Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the previous video, we have seen that how the MOSFET can be used as a switch. So in the next couple of videos, we will understand that how the MOSFET can be used as an amplifier. Now when we want to use the MOSFET as an amplifier, then it needs to be biased properly. So first of all, let us understand how to bias the MOSFET properly so that it can be used as an amplifier. And first of all, we will start with the depletion type of MOSFET. So to use this MOSFET as an amplifier, it needs to be biased in the active region, or for the MOSFET, it is also called the saturation region. Now the transfer characteristic of this depletion type of MOSFET is similar to the JFET. The only difference is that the transfer curve is extended beyond this IDSS. That means for the n-channel MOSFET, it works for the positive values of the VGS, while for the p-channel MOSFET, it also works for the negative values of VGS. And whenever it is operated beyond the IDSS, then it is called the enhancement region. And likewise, whenever it is operated below this IDSS, then that region of operation is called the depletion region of operation. And if we see the drain curves or the ID versus VDS curves, then they are similar to the JFET. But now, we also get the curves for the positive values of the VGS. So to operate the MOSFET in the active region, the VDS should be greater than or equal to VGS minus VP. And in this region, the drain current can be given by the Shockley's equation. Now similar to the JFET, there are three basic biasing techniques for this depletion type of MOSFET. That is fixed bias, self bias and the voltage divider bias. And since the transfer characteristics are similar to the JFET, the analysis of these biasing techniques is also very similar. So in detail, we have already seen all these biasing techniques for the JFET. So here, for the depletion type of MOSFET, we will quickly go through all these biasing techniques. And first of all, let us start with the fixed bias. So in the fixed bias configuration, a fixed voltage is applied at the gate terminal. And since the gate current IG is approximately equal to 0, so if we apply the KVL in this loop, then we can say that voltage VGS is equal to minus VGG, right? And for the active region of operation, the drain current ID can be given by the Shockley's equation. So for any MOSFET, the typical values of this IDSS and the VP are already known. So by putting the value of VGS in this expression, we can find the value of the drain current. And using the drain current, we can find the value of the VDS. So if we apply the KVL in this output side, then we can say that voltage VDD minus ID times RD, that is the voltage drop across this drain resistor, minus VDS is equal to 0. Or we can say that voltage VDS is equal to VDD minus ID times RD. So in this way, using the mathematical approach, we can find the drain current and the voltage VDS. So similarly, now let us see the graphical approach. So here, this blue curve shows the transfer characteristic of the MOSFET. And for the fixed bias configuration, this straight line is the load line. Because here, irrespective of the change in the drain current, the voltage VGS will remain fixed. So the intersection of the load line and the transfer curve will give us the operating point. That means this will be the drain current IDQ and this will be the VGSQ. And for the fixed bias configuration, it is also possible to bias the MOSFET in the enhancement region. That means using the positive value of the gate supply voltage, it is possible to bias the MOSFET in the enhancement region. Now, as we have discussed earlier, the operating point in the fixed bias configuration is very susceptible to the change in the MOSFET parameters. For example, for any MOSFET, the value of IDSS and the VP can vary in the certain range. That means if we take the two similar type of MOSFETs, then the two MOSFETs can have a different values of IDSS and the VP. So in the particular MOSFET circuit, if we replace the MOSFET with another similar type of MOSFET, then the variation in the operating point should be minimum. Let's say for one MOSFET, these are the maximum values of the IDSS and the VP. and this green curve shows the minimum values of these IDSS and the VP. So in this case, this is the maximum variation in the drain current. That means if we replace the MOSFET in the circuit with another similar type of MOSFET, then in the worst case, this is the maximum variation in the drain current. So this variation in the operating point can be reduced by using the self-bias configuration. So as you can see, unlike the fixed bias, here there is no additional supply at the gate terminal. And in addition to that, here the resistor is connected at the source terminal. So for the DC analysis, all these coupling capacitors will act as an open circuit. Alright, so first of all, using the mathematical analysis, let us find the operating point for this self-bias configuration. And here, once again, this gate current IG will be approximately equal to 0. That means there will not be any voltage drop across this resistor RG. And in this case, the current through this source resistor is equal to ID. Because here, this ID is equal to IS. So if we apply the KVL in this loop, then we can say that voltage VGS is equal to minus ID times RS. And in the active region, the drain current ID can be given by the Shockley's expression. So by putting the value of this VGS in this expression and solving it for the drain current ID, we can find the operating drain current for the given circuit. And then after, by applying the KVL on the output side, we can find the value of the VDS. That means VDS is equal to VDD minus ID times RD plus RS. So in this way, using this mathematical approach, we can find the operating drain current and the value of the VDS for the self-bias configuration. So similarly, now let us see the graphical approach. So here, this blue curve shows the transfer curve for the particular MOSFET. And here, since VGS is equal to minus ID times RS, so this load line will pass through the origin. And the intersection of this load line with the transfer curve will give us the operating point. So let's say these are the maximum values of the IDSS and the VP. And this green curve shows the minimum values of the IDSS and the VP. So in that case, this will be the maximum variation in the drain current. So as you can see, compared to the fixed bias configuration, here the variation in the operating point is lower. But further, this variation can be reduced by using the voltage divider biasing. So by adding the fixed gate voltage, the slope of this load line can be reduced further. And because of that, the variation in the operating point can be reduced further. So when we want to use the single supply, then we can use this voltage divider bias. That means using the single supply, using this voltage divider bias, we can apply a specific voltage at the gate terminal. So first of all, using the mathematical approach, let us find the operating point for the given configuration. And for the DC analysis, all these coupling capacitors will act as an open circuit. So here, since this gate current IG is equal to 0, so no current is flowing into the gate terminal. That means from the supply, the current is flowing through this resistor R1 and the R2. And using the voltage divider rule, we can find the voltage at this gate terminal. That means voltage VG is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times VDD. And once again, the current through this source resistor RS is equal to ID. That means if we apply the KVL in this loop, then we can find the expression of the VGS. That means VGS is equal to VG minus ID times RS. Now, since we have already seen this voltage divider biasing configuration for the JFET in detail, so here I am quickly going through the analysis. But for more information, you can check those videos. Anyway, so in the active region, the drain current ID can be given by the Shockley's equation. And by putting the value of VGS in this expression and solving that quadratic equation for the drain current ID, we can find the value of the drain current. And this voltage VDS can be given as voltage VDD minus ID times RD plus RS. So in this way, we can find the operating drain current and the voltage VDS for this voltage divider biasing configuration. Now graphically if we see, then this yellow line shows the load line. That means in this expression, whenever the drain current ID is equal to 0, then the voltage VGS is equal to VG. And similarly, when voltage VGS is equal to 0, then this drain current ID is equal to VG divided by RS, that is this point. So by joining these two points, we will get the load line. And by extending this line, we can find the intersection point with this transfer curve. And this intersection point will give us the operating point. Now as I mentioned, in case of this voltage divider biasing configuration, the variation in the operating point is lesser compared to the self-bias configuration. So if these are the minimum values of the IDSS and the VP, then this is the maximum variation in the operating point. So compared to all the three biasing configurations, this voltage divider biasing configuration is more robust in terms of the operating point stability. Now so far in our discussion, we have only talked about the N-channel MOSFET. But similarly, it is also possible to bias the P-channel MOSFET. So if we see the transfer characteristic of this P-channel MOSFET, then it is exactly mirror image of the N-channel MOSFET. And in this case, the value of VGS is positive. And in the enhancement region, it will also work for the negative values of VGS. So in terms of the biasing, the only change is in the polarity of the supply voltage. So here, the supply voltage is negative and the direction of the drain current is opposite compared to the N-channel MOSFET. Otherwise, the analysis will remain the same. So on the second channel, I will try to cover some examples on each configuration and we will also see some examples for this P-channel MOSFET. And you can also check this playlist on the JFET and the MOSFET for any update. But I hope in this video, you got an overview of the different biasing configuration of the depletion type of MOSFET. So in the next video, similarly we will see the different biasing configuration for the enhancement type of MOSFET. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.